This is coming from 06 to 05, the syllabus, yeah. And year to 2019 question paper system. Yeah. We start from number 1, A, B, A, B, dan seterusnya. A, B, A first maybe, yeah. A student is investigating moment using a balancing method. Yeah, figure 1-1 shows the apparatus. Itu ada W on the P, distance with pivot A, and Q, yeah, on the meter ruler. Nah, sekarang the student place the meter ruler without loop on the pivot and adjust its position so that the meter rule is near a possible to being balanced. Jadi dideketin supaya dia balance, ya. She keeps the rule in this position on the pivot throughout the experiment. Explain briefly why the position on the pivot might not be exactly at the 50.0 centimeter mark of the rule. Oh, ini ya, karena center of mass-nya beda, ya. Center of mass, ya. Yeah. Or center of gravity, yeah, is not in center. It's not in center. Ah, seperti itu. Karena mesh-nya sudah berpindah, ya. One minute. The center of me. Okay, continue. B, C place of load P, yeah, of the metal so that the edge that further from the pivot is actually at the 10 centimeter mark on the rule. Okay. She measures the distance between this edge on the load P and pivot as in figure 1-1. Oh, on the table. She places a load Q on the meter rule and adjust the position of load Q so that the meter rule is as near the position to being balanced. Yeah. She measure distance B between the center of load Q and the pivot, yeah, as shown in figure 1-1. She repeats the procedure with the edge of the load P that is farther from the pivot on the 15, 20, 25, 30 centimeter mark. Yeah. All the readings on table 1-1. Nah, ini setelah digeser P tadi, ya. Yeah. Membikin apa center of position ruler itu di angka ini. Then, wah, harus digambar, guys. Digambar. Oke deh, coba kalau digambar gimana kita. Plot a diagram A in y-axis, B in x-axis. Start both origin 0-0. Ini kan until 50, ini until 40. Bisa nggak? Oh, gini aja. Kita bikin intent aja deh. Ya. A B in centimeter. This is A in centimeter also. Yeah. This is 0. This is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And also this is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, oh 60, yeah, this is 60. Ada salah nggak? 1, 2. Satu, dua, tiga, empat, lima, satu, dua, tiga. Oh, yes, correct. Okay, let's see ya. Ini yang A 3844. A 3844. 3844. Wait ya. Kalian nanti sana juga boleh sambil mengerjakan itu ya. 3844. 3844. 3844. Ya, maybe di sini ya. Ini Bapak tidak ini ya, asal aja ya, tapi yang dekat
28, 33, 28, 33, 28, 33, then 23, 27, 23, 27, here, last one, 18, 22, 18, 22, 18, 22, here, done.
So, if we draw the line, ya, draw the line, berarti gini ya, kita gerset, aduh, kurang, kurang ke bawah. Nah, berarti ini kalau diteruskan gini guys. Nah, ya nanti bikin garis yang lurus deh ya. Agak susah nih Bapak, harus pakai ruler. Ya. Aduh, kelewat. Sorry ya. Done, oke. Okay. Then, if we continue. Okay, now determine the gradient g of the graph. So clearly, graph how you obtain the necessary. Okay, gradient g, ya. Ini kan delta y per delta x ya. Kita gunakan ini aja deh. Delta y-nya itu kan 38, ya, negatif 18 divided 44.5 minus 22, ya. Nah, kira-kira berapa itu gradiennya? The gradient about 0.88, ya, 89, ya. I use the method of triangle, ya. Ini kan delta y per delta x slope. So this is about 0.89. And Rama, we back again. D question. Determine the intercept C on the x-axis on the graph. Oh, maybe negatif something ya on the x-axis. Apa graph-nya ini ya, Bapak ya? Harusnya mungkin gini guys, graph-nya ya. Ini Bapak kan tadi kira-kira ya. Mungkin harusnya crossing with x-axis. Ini mungkin gini. Aduh, jelek. Ini x ya, apa crossing with x itu adalah di 0.2 ya, 0.2 or in 2 actually 2 ya. Ini adalah di 2 ya, 2.0. Karena ternyata maybe tadi Bapak ini kurang tepat. Ini dia intersepsi on the x-axis. And then measure the width W, the load P. W, the load P. Width. Kita ngambil dari mana? Ini sebentar. Kalau kita lihat. Oh, I know. Oh, bukan. The loop itu W. Oh ini guys, kalian lihat E ini selisihnya, kemudian a half ini ya. Nah, gini. From this ya. W itu adalah A min B divided 2. Yeah. So A min B. Oh, langsung A min B. Yeah. Kalau kalian lihat ini kan. Nah, ini lebar ini ya. A min B. Itu. Kurang lebih. Oh, ini harus pakai penggaris. Ini maybe sekitar 2.5 ya, sentimeter. Ya. Karena ini measure V. Ini pakai penggaris ketika kita udah di print out ya. Ketika udah di print out, ini lebarnya kira-kira berapa? It's about 2.5 ya, about 2.5. Okay, we check other question F. Another student suggests that the value of intercept C should be equal to half width W. Okay. Of the load P, state whether result support suggestion. Justify your answer by reference to the result. Itu susah ya, menaruh posisi yang tepat di meter roll itu pasti akan bergeser-geser sedikit. Oke, nanti kalian bisa jelaskan seperti itu. Oke, sekarang number 2 ya. Boleh dilihat dulu. Yes, question 2. A student is investigating the rate of cooling of water under different conditions. A greater rate of cooling occurs if there is greater change in temperature during the same period in time. Okay, figure 2.1, figure 2.2 show the apparatus used. Beaker A has a lid. Beaker B is on the mat made of the same material as lid. The mat and the lid have same thickness. So different ya, berarti ini on the figure 2.1 they use lid ya. And the 2.2 they have mat ya on the bottom of beaker. The thermometer in figure 2.3 show in the room temperature delta R at the beginning of the experiment. Record delta R. Okay, delta R, theta R ya. Yeah. This is 22 ya, yeah, 22. So, kita put 22 on this blank, yeah. 22 degree in Celsius. Yeah. Actually, we only record ya, yeah. Not like eksperimen. Kita hanya nge-record, nggak melakukan eksperimen. Oke, kita lihat berikutnya. The student pours 200 cm cubic of hot water into beaker A. He places the lid on the beaker and places the thermometer in the beaker as shown figure 2.1. Yeah. He records the temperature theta of hot water times 0. Yeah. He immediately start the stop clock. The record the time and temperature readings every 30 seconds until he has 6 sets of readings. He repeats the procedure using beaker B. The beaker is on the mat has mat but has a no lid. Okay. The reading are shown table 2.1 and table 2.2. Okay. 1. Complete the column heading in the table 2.1 and table 2.0. The heading is unit of T and theta, yeah. T is in second and theta is in degree Celsius. This is also same thing in second and this is in degree Celsius. Yeah. Done. Question 2. Look carefully at the readings 2.1 and 2.2. Tick the box to show your conclusion from the readings. Kalian lihat ini 81, 80, 79, 70. Ini little bit delay ya, agak sedikit lambat ini turun suhunya. So R-nya jadi apa kira-kira? The lead reduced the rate cooling the water significantly more than met reduced rate cooling water. Significant? Enggak juga ya. The met reduced the rate cooling of water significantly more than lead reduced the rate cooling. Tapi ini enggak juga ya. Ini 75 ini juga. 75. There is no significant difference between the lead met reducing the rate cooling of the water. Ini kayaknya nggak terlalu ini juga. Ini kan start from 83 ya. 81 ini 83. Ini agak tinggi. Kayaknya ini deh. The box ya. There is no significant difference between the lead and the met in reducing the rate of cooling on the water of the water. Question I 3, justify your conclusion by reference to the quoting temperature from the table in the same time. Oke, seperti itu ya, Jos Rama. Kalau mau dilihat-lihat dulu, silakan. Okay, we continue to see other question, C question until F. Yeah. A student plans to repeat the experiment using same apparatus and the same volume of water. Suggest one change to the procedure that will decrease the rate of cooling of the water. About lower starting initial temperature, yeah, or higher room temperature. Yeah, maybe. D. State one precaution that you must take in order to record accurate temperature readings. One precaution. Viewing. Perpendicular viewing. Yeah. Intermeter view. At eye level. Yeah. Jadi kalau kita ini this is our eye, so thermometer, let's say ini ya. So this is on the right angle or perpendicular. It suggests two variables that must be controlled in order to make the experiment in fair test. Room temperature. And the second one is bigger glass. Ini juga sama. Same volume. Constant volume. That's it. Last one, F. It is important to view a measuring cylinder correctly to obtain an accurate value of the volume of a lid. Tick the box that gives the best description of how the to read the measuring cylinder. The line slides along the vertical. Oh, tadi guys, ini right angle ya, on the third box. Ini yang benar ya. Line slide, line sight, ya, line of sight, apa garis penglihatannya itu should be in right angle to the scale, ya. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, number three, a student is investigating she uses the circuit on feature 3.1. This is power supply and then ammeter and then this is lampu ya. Yeah. P ini resistor ya. Yeah. And V is voltmeter. Write down the reading shown in meters in figure 3.2, 3.33. Oh, kita pindahkan aja ini. V itu ini 3 point, ini kan 4 ya. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3.6. Ini 3.6 ya. Dan ini 0 point, ini tepat di tengah 0.3 ya. Yeah. This is in voltmeter, in volt ya. Yeah. And ini in amperes. Cuma lihat apa namanya skala pembacaan. Oke, kemudian calculate the resistance R1 of the resistor P using equation R1. Oh, ini kan kita bagi saja guys. Ini R itu kan jadi tadi ya 3.6 divided 0.3. 3.6 divided 0.3. Ini 36 bagi 3 12 ohms ya. 12 ohms. Then the student connect the voltmeter across the lamp L. She record potential difference V2 across the lamp L is 2.4 volt. Calculate resistance R2 of the lamp using R2 satu itu dari, oh kan kita ada current ya. Nah, dari sini nih, Jos. R2 itu dari 2.4 divided 0.3. 8 ya. 8 ohms. Ya. Then ada lagi R3. The student replaced the resistor P with the resistor Q. She records the potential difference V3 across resistor Q and the current I2 in the circuit. Yeah. Calculate the resistance R3 on the resistor Q using ya tadi aja kita bagi aja ya. 3.5 divided 11.3. This is about 11.3 ya, yeah, ohms. Ya, seperti itu. Kalau mau ditulis silakan Jos and Rama dipahami. Bapak tunggu kurang lebih 3 menit ya. Okay, Josh and Rama. Ya, apa ini? State whether result R1 and R3 suggest the resistor P and resistor Q have the same value resistor within the limit experimental accuracy. Justify your statement by reference to your result. Ini nanti sendiri ya. Apakah hampir sama nih antara R1 and R3? Apa beda ya? Ini little bit different ya. Different but 0.7. Bit different by 0.7. Oke. Sekarang I. The student connect to the voltmeter across the lamp L. Okay. She record the potential difference V4 across the lamp 2.5 volt. She calculates the resistor R4 or the lamp is 8.1. Yeah. She suggests that the change in resistance on the lamp of the lamp from part C is due to change in temperature of the lamp filament. Suggests on observation that she could make continue confirm that the temperature of the lamp filament changes. Apa tuh? Suggest. This is about brightness or intensity of light. Yeah. Ini tentang brightness. Or intensity of light. Karena dia bilang lamp filament ya. Okay. And F question, complete the circuit diagram in figure 3.4 to show that two resistor and the lamp are connected in parallel. The voltmeter is connected to measure the potential difference across the resistors. The lamp. Oh. Two resistor and the lamp. Two resistors. And the lamp are connected. Oh, berarti gini dong. Two resistor connected. The lamp are all connected in parallel. Jadi gini guys. Berarti ini resistor and lamp ya. The voltmeter is connected to measure the potential difference across the resistor and the lamp. Oh, parallel also here voltmeter. Karena voltmeter itu harus in parallel ya. Nah, baru seperti ini, guys. That's it. Nah, two resistor, yeah, two resistors and the lamp are all connected in parallel. Yeah. The voltmeter is connected to measure the potential difference across the resistors and the lamp. Yes, correct this one. Okay. That's it. Maybe one more question. State the name of the circuit component that you want add to circuit you have drawn to the control current in the circuit. This we use variable resistor. Yeah, yes, variable resistor. Lanjut lagi ya. Sekarang udah number 4. Yeah. Number 4 is about maybe ini mah harus di kalian yang menjelaskan ya. Coba kita baca dulu deh. Student is investigating the relationship between the thickness of converging convex lens and its focal length, feature 4.1. So the cross section of converging lens. The focal length f of the lens can be calculated if u, the distance between the object and the lens, yeah, and v, the distance between the lens and the image on the screen are known. The equation is We have provided both equation that F equals to UV divided U plus V. Yeah. The thickness is T. Yeah. Plan an experiment to investigate the relationship between the thickness T, yeah, and the focal length F of converging lenses. You may add to figure 4.1 as part of your answer. Ya, oke. Okay. Katanya apa aja nih? The following apparatus is available to student: illuminated object, ya, selection of lens difference thickness and lens holder, screen, meter rule, 30 cm ruler, and two rectangular wooden blocks with the longest side longer than diameter of lens. Okay, ini beberapa aparatus yang digunakan ya. Jadi, ini mungkin ya, kalau kita gambarkan ini lenses, ya, lens ya, lens. Then ini apa namanya, paralel axis. And we have object here. Yeah. This object. With this distant object as U, yeah, and then this is maybe screen. This is screen, yeah. Then maybe meter rule, yeah, to record U and V, yeah, U and V, this is V, yeah. Let's say you get image, yeah, here, yeah. So V is distance of object to the lens, yeah, with the thickness T, and so on and so on. Jadi nanti kalian bisa bercerita tentang itu ya. Nah, ini kan draw the diagram, ya. Draw the diagram to show arrangement the apparatus labeling U and V, dan ya, U and V, ya. Labeling U and V, dan explain briefly how you will carry out the investigation, including the measurement you would like, you would take, ya. Ya, measuring about U and V after several times, you change the position between U and then we get, you get the position V. Ya. Dengan mengubah jarak U ini, nanti kan dapat jarak V. Ya. Explain briefly you would determine the thickness T on your lens to my draw diagram. Thickness ini nanti mungkin ya selisih selisih jarak antara U dan V ini ya. Ini kan thickness-nya itu di sini ya. Draw the stable table with column heading to show how would display readings. You don't know need equation. Oh, oke. Okay. Ya, maybe ini kita punya U V ya. U V. This is number 1, 2 until sometimes we use about 6 set, yeah. U in centimeter and V also in centimeter, yeah. But we don't need to find to calculate focal length, yeah. Yeah, ini. Yeah. Okay.